see you.
Good to see you.
Hi, how are you?
Hi.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
President Indiana is still chair.
I was just wondering.
How are you? Please sit down.
Thanks.
Well, I'm grateful to all of you for taking your time away from what my own experience I remember is a kind of a busy season. Fiscal year is coming to an end, budget talk and all. But I thank you for your interest in our tax reform. I believe that your leadership can make all the difference in getting this accomplished. And by the way, I'm very sorry that we couldn't work out that stop. I was hoping to know that. Chuck. I thank all of you for your hospitality and my recent visits. They sent me back here feeling a little better and about the whole world in all those places. We feel that you know what we're trying to achieve with fairness, simplicity, and lower tax rates that we think could help stimulate and keep going economic growth. We feel that repealing the deduction of state and local taxes is necessary to make those goals a reality. And I know that you're coming under some very severe pressure on that particular issue. And I just want to thank you for express my admiration for the courage that you've shown in standing up to that. I happen to believe that, and have ever since I've been here, and because of my previous experience, that the greatest thing and the best thing that we can do the federal level is reduce the share the federal government is taking so that there is leeway at the state and local levels. I know from that past experience that there were times when there was a necessary function and something that you felt would require a tax to implement it. And yet you looked at the whole tax burden and principally the federal government's share of it, and you didn't see any leeway there to impose on the people to do that. And I recall that when I was making my first vote, the total burden a taxpayer of government was about 10 cents, roughly, of the earned dollar. And of that, two-thirds went to state and local governments where the necessary functions of education, personal safety, and so forth were all involved, and less than a third went to the federal government. And now, three-fifths of not a dime, but three-fifths of about 35 to 40 cents that we're taking is going to the federal government, leaving two-fifths of the state and local level. And I just feel that this tax reform could be a part of that, of getting back to being able to reduce the burden of the federal government and allowing that other area open for you. But now I'd like to hear from you and how you feel. And Lamar, why don't you take off and go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. President, and I'm glad next week instead of staying here on the job.
Does that mean I don't get to go to California?
I don't know whether you're going to. He's staying.
He's going to do the Reagan roundup for you.
And he's sick about it. You think I was made of those Shiites before?
You'll be mispronouncing the word Reagan.
You bet. That reminds me.
Max, do you want to bring us up to date?
Yes, sir. The congressional schedule this week.
Time is limited.
I know that. I'm not as pleased to
take the chair.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Honey, the biggest thing I'm working on now is, you know, cancer.
Yeah.
We're losing 400,000 people a year in this country from cancer. If we were at war, we're losing 400,000 people a year.
Yeah.
The people would say, we've got to do something about it. Now, you honored me. You gave me this big job. And you've reappointed me for another 3 years. I took the thing out of Washington, and I went out in the field to visit all the centers to see what they were doing with $1 billion a year, which we're giving them, to see what are we getting for our money. And I must say, I found a lot of things that needed improvement. But that wasn't what I was after. I was thinking, we've got to stop this scourge. We've got to get rid of it. We got rid of diphtheria. We got rid of smallpox. We got rid of typhoid fever. They were all diseases, and cancer, after all, is a disease. We've got to get rid of it. Now, I want to get rid of it during your term as presidency, and I think we can do it. Now, recently they asked Nixon, what are you most proud of? He said that I put through the bill 10 years ago for the Cancer Act. I want you to be able to say that I got the answer. I just didn't put through the bill, but I got the thing accomplished. Now, we have done more in the last few months than in 25 years that they've been working on cancer research. I give a prize every year, you may have heard about it, $100,000 every year, whoever does the best work. A few months ago,
Nice to see you.
The best constituents I have is Miriam.
Hello.
And Jimmy Crum. Jimmy is the recipient of the Sertoma Humanitarian Award.
Yes.
Thank you.
And I congratulate you.
Thank you, sir. Very kind.
Following your philosophy of helping people, this man helps more people than anybody I think we ever can meet. He's just a fantastic man. Crippled children's. Easter Seals, Recreation Unlimited.
I was with two football coaches the other night who have helped a lot of people, who have to be remembered to you, Woody Hayes and the Colts.
Well, for these things.
This is something, I know you were a sportscaster in Iowa.
Yep.
But we'd like for you to be maybe an honorary Buckeye, because you're number one as well. You're number one with us.
All right. Well, listen, I appreciate very much all that you've done, and I remember, as a matter of fact, when I was broadcasting Big Ten football back there, and Shoal Mercy Schmidt.
Francis Schmidt at Ohio State.
Those great teams.
That's right. And, we still have some great teams, and that rivalry between Ohio State and Iowa has been, next to the Ohio State-Michigan, is probably one of the most fierce rivalries in the Big Ten, with Forrest Evershefsky having done such a great job at Iowa for so many years.
I have to tell you, I was one of the few sportscasters broadcasting, I think it was, Iowa was playing Temple at the time, but on the same day was when Notre Dame was playing that great Ohio State team that had been hailed as the one that was going to dominate the country that year.
1935.
And Notre Dame had dedicated their game to their captain who had been killed that summer in an accident. And with 2 minutes to go, Notre Dame scored 3 touchdowns in 2 minutes to win 18 to
13. 18 to 13. Shakespeare was the man who He's a big hero.
All the people in my broadcasting booth had been making fun and so forth about it. I am the only one who predicted that Notre Dame would win.
Well, they still talk about that. In 3 years from now, Ohio State will play Notre Dame again. They're back on the schedule again. In, well, 1990.
Listen, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
I'm glad to have this. And again, congratulations.
Thank you,
sir. More than that, thanks for all that you're doing.
Well, I know what you're doing. Thank you, sir.
I should have been talking about myself in my days.
It's a labor of love, President Reagan. It really is, with the kids, and it's a labor of love.
Well, that's just great.
Thank you, sir.
I am honored.
Good to see you.
Sue and Lancoe.
Yes. Hello there. Nice to see you, Mr. President. Good to see you.
Sue's been named National Physical Educator of the Year, Mr. President.
I know. So congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Well, I think it's a most worthwhile thing. I'm hard to sell with a favor, anything of that kind.
I hope so.
Yes, sir.
I brought you something from our school. You'll accept it. It's a Bayhawk from Chesapeake High School in Baltimore County.
Well, say my heartfelt thanks for that.
We're right on the Chesapeake Bay.
Yes, I know. We have a nature center down there, a federal wildlife center on the bay. I was down there and visited. In fact, saw some eagles while I was there. I noticed that eagles were all over the west.
We used to.
Well, that's, thank you very much.
Very good. Thank you, Mr. President, for your time and for this opportunity.
You got some pictures here that.
Very good.
Well. I don't know why the perfectionists, the purists, should have ever objected to the Truman balcony. I think it asked the building. You know, it was a big fuss, so they raised hell about him putting that balcony out there. I tell you, from living here for a few years, thank God for that balcony.
The last name is pronounced Newt.
Newt.
And the artist is, her name looks like Sherry, but it's pronounced Sherry. Sherry Newt and her family. No trust for that. Covers of this. Very good.
Mr. President,
how are you? Glad to see you. Good to see you. Thank
Sherry Newt and her family.
Ms. Newt. Hello there.
So nice to meet
you. Pretty lady, pretty daughter, and pretty mother.
Hello there.
This is her mother. How are you doing? Nice to see you. Hello. Hello. Make yourself up.
You're a congressman.
How you doing?
You're looking great. Keep it up.
Well, listen, I thank the both of you for bringing these wonderful people in, and you, and I have to say, it is.
Are you pleased with it?
Oh, my goodness. This happens to be my very favorite view of the White House. We come by sometimes, having been out, and come around to the gate to come in through here. I just look up there, and it's just magnificent. You really have done it beautifully.
Thank you. It's such a
beautiful view. A photograph, you know, you could assume that would be a nice photograph, but that's a painting.
I know.
And I know what anybody could paint that. Well, I don't see. It's a gift from God. And so I just
look like a photograph. That's magnificent.
You said you were over there. Thank you, Mr. President.
All right.
Should Constance, you want to come?
No. Yes. Yeah. Have you gotten a picture of all of us?
Yes.
Well, thank you.
And also for you and Mrs. Reagan. It is just personalized for you, but that's something that you have to keep it now because of your name going.
Believe me, we'll keep it, and with great pleasure. Thank you very much.
And Gregory has some note cards for Nancy.
Thank you so much.
To say, well, thank you very much. I make sheep and needles myself. Brother does kiss men and women.
Oh, okay.
We want to do one formal picture here if we can, but before we finish.
Stand by.
Yes.
Pleased to see you and thank you for
bringing. We're honored to introduce you to the University of Utah gymnastics team.
Hello, Mr. President. How are you? Nice to meet you.
Nice to see you.
Mr. President, I'd like to introduce you to Megan Marshall, my wife.
There.
I'm the Coast. Yeah.
See you.
Hello, Lisa Mitchell.
Nice to see you.
This is Wendy Wyden.
When did you do that?
This is Tina Hammer.
Hello there.
This is Cheryl Weatherstone.
Hi.
This is Lisa McVeigh.
Good to see you.
Carolee Novak.
Hi.
Good to see you.
Hi.
Sandy Sabatka.
Hello.
Celeste Harrington, our other co-captains. Elaine Alfano, our other co-captains.
Good to see you. Good to see you. Good to see you.
Or your wife, so that's a jacket, but you need to swear.
Well, she would be very pleased and happy to have you.
Bill Sands, my assistant.
How are you here? Hello. Ted Kegner, vice president of the university, and we have a jacket also for you. To make you an honorary team member, President Ronald Reagan, something to keep you warm. You need it on days like this.
Thanks
for having us.
Thank you.
Our captain's pleasure.
Mr. President, we're not quite as tall as the Lakers, but we're able to flip a little bit easier. But this is a little something for you from our team, and we were always told that we're from our fans and from our teammates that we're a very close-knit family. And this is a sketch that somebody did for us, and this is a real good example.
Well,
these aren't all the girls that are here, but
well, thank you.
We all represent the team.
Five times in a row. that really is something, and I'm very proud to see all of you, and I think we ought to get a team picture in here. All
we have all the people on the side just sit down here. And it survived.
Can I just say with regard to
now just let everybody get where you can see the camera.
If you can see us, we can see you. But if you are having trouble seeing the camera, this is perfect.
Great.
Well, I want you to know, as you mentioned, those other teams that have been coming in here got the bad people. This is so much more pleasant. I can tell you that the last team was in the pro champ when they came in, and one of them had to duck. I don't know whether he really had to or whether he just felt it. But he was certainly that close that he got him coming through.
None of these girls will have to do that.
When I had a picture taken, and it was put on the cover of Sports Illustrated. I mean, they came and took the picture with me standing between you and him. His coach.
I didn't remember that.
And when I saw the cover of the magazine, I thought I was sitting down.
Mr. President, the university has asked me to present to you two Block U pins also. Well, one for you and one for your good wife.
Well, thank you. I'm very pleased and proud to have these.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks
for meeting with us. I think it's kind of nice, too, what your covers are.
Red and white.
asking to myself, that's our favorite color. Choose anything, as long as it's red.
Thank you. We wish you well in these difficult times.
Yes. Can I ask a favor?
Can
you sign my
pass? If you got a hand.
What do you mean five-time champions coming into it?
It's the right color, huh?
Yeah. This was a postseason operation. It came after the championship.
One of the tougher signatures you'll have to do.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations for being selected to do this.
I'm Mary Danforth,
Mr. President.
Oh, yeah. Nice to see you.
Hi. How are you?
Good to see you. Good to see you.
Well,
I think this is, you just wanted to vote on behalf of the people, even though you say something very proudly.
Accept it.
And again, as I say, congratulations on having been chosen to do this.
Mr. President, this gives you a legal title for the property.
Well, thank you very much. Is he getting us all, everybody in, or should we?
Come on, Harold.
Yes.
Do you have the frog down?
Yes, I do. Mr. President, while I was carving this sculpture, I unveiled the cloth of clay one day, and there was a tree frog that had been living inside my sculpture. And I was a Mark Twain's jumping frog story. Sculpted a frog sitting where my frog
That's great. You know, I think it, no one can boast of being a fan of my twins. I think we all are. But just on the chance that maybe I know a story that you don't know about him. He was supposed to be on shipboard and the diving salon one night. He asked a gentleman at the table to pass the sugar. And the gentleman, wanting to show off a little bit, said to him, he said, don't you find this, that sugar is the only word in the English language in which the S-U sound has the sh sound? And Twain said, are you sure? Well, I think America will be very proud to have this. I'm very pleased to accept it.
Thank you.
Mr. President, this being the sesquicentennial year of Mark Twain's birth, Hamilton, Missouri, I was marking this in full stride, and I would like to present you with a ball cap celebrating the sesquicentennial of Mark Twain's birth. There are actually two for you to add to your collection.
Well, thank you very much. I'm very pleased to have these. All right.
Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello there.
You are my favorite people.
Well, thank you very much.
Oh, it's so wonderful. This is my dog. Wildflowers from our farm. I try to think of something that you don't get very often in Washington, and I thought wildflowers would be something.
Yes, very good. And thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Very pleased to hear that. Well, thank you.
This is Mrs. Ada.
I'm Louise Ayon, her sister.
This is my best friend here.
I'm just tagging along.
Ms. Decker, you better take this and give it to her. She's so excited.
And this is what I did for you.
Thank you very much.
You know who it is.
But I understood it was only going to be about that big around.
No, that's it. The one that size is the butler. And
she did two of them.
She has a photograph of the one the butler to give you.
I don't have the care.
And I brought one here to show you. This gives you an idea of the size. And see if you know who that is.
Well, tonight I will be making a little speech at Teddy Kennedy's library.
I'm the Duke Johnson next. I've done, I did Nixon and Carter and Ford. No. Carter and Ford.
Johnson.
But yours was just finished. And I was inspired to do this.
Thank you very much.
Is this like the one that's going in the bottle?
No, it's different.
Now, this lady wants to tell you something else.
Yes, sir, I want to tell you how much we appreciate your stay alive tonight. There are so many babies I know are going to live because you have been strong enough to stand up to all the flack that you've gotten. And we appreciate it. There's so many people praying for you and supporting you. And we love you very much, very much.
And this is my daughter.
And I brought a book for you. I don't know if you ever have time to read it, but it's by E.W. Kenyon. And it's a beautiful book. It's two kinds of righteousness. And I just thought if you ever have time, it's a skinny one.
I shall.
Okay, he's a great, he's great. So. Oh, and this goes with the picture.
Yes,
this goes with the picture. We're just going to weigh you down here.
There's a photograph in there of the Manitou at the bottom.
Oh.
It's a museum.
I think I'll try to open it up.
Yeah. Yes, I think
you
I
got your hands hand full.
Yes, you have.
Well.
We appreciate your
this is
seeing us.
And I'll tell them it's about the most exciting day of my life to come in.
Well, I thank you. I'm kind of pleased that you made
it. I'm asking over to a dozen. And he told me to tell you that he thinks that you made it possible for Archmore to be our company.
Oh.
I said, please tell him that.
No, we were governors together. I was a great friend of mine.
Brother, thank you so much.
You see, thank you.
And see you tomorrow.
You want to do a quick group photo, Senator?
Sure.
Good. Quick group photo.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Senator.
We'll take a group photo of you.
Oh, all right. Hey, where are you?
I'm going to
hold this one.
Okay.
Just this book.
That'll take all day.
Hold that out.
Good. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you for seeing us, sir.
It's a great pleasure to be here tonight. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye. Bye, Mr. President.
Well.
Such a nice treat. Two pictures with you.
It's a little more formal than just there on the airplane.
That's right. Thank you very much. I appreciate your time again.
Well, great pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.